I want to look at an area where I think we could see a big divergent step, and that is in how we pay for things in retail, and a complete move away from the old credit cards, cash cards, in fact, every other kind of card. I want us to imagine a world where all payments are going to mobile, all ticketing goes to mobile, and just about everything in our life is now within a smartphone type device. You know, of course, that the UK transaction market is around £600 or £700 billion a year in terms of credit cards. We're looking at credit card debt of around £50 billion, average credit card interest rate 16, 17, 18%. It's a fabulous market for those who are in it. And the 2% commissions are in this country are worth £20 billion alone, which raises an interesting question about what would happen if telcos started to invade this space. What would happen if Vodafone decided to go into partnership, say, with Google and American Express and, let's say, Nokia, to produce a new proprietary payment system? Could it happen? Yes, it could. In my back pocket, I have a whole stack of credit cards. They're all wireless-enabled. All of them have got the same technology inside, as you well know. If you've ever taken one of these things to bits, there's nothing in it. It's just plastic and a tiny grain of sand under the metal and a little aerial. It's just a radio frequency identification device like the other trillion of these things around the world now, attached to the clothing that you're wearing, in your tie, in your shoes. There's probably 500 or 600 at least RFIDs in this room right now. The big question is, what happens if you just put the RFID inside the casing of the phone? You don't need to worry about any kind of complex technology, just a little grain of sand embedded in the plastic, and suddenly we've got the credit card technology in here. We've got the ability to get money from the bank by going near the bank with my phone rather than the credit card itself. In fact, why do we need the credit card? The credit cards look so last century to me. What would happen if we went a little further? You see, the technology cost, the cost of providing technology is falling rapidly towards zero. The cost of providing you unlimited bandwidth to watch videos on a smartphone, the cost of giving you a new smartphone every year is falling towards zero, the cost of giving you an additional iPad for your family and a Windows computer plus a satellite TV receiving machine plus a Sky subscription and all the movies you could possibly imagine you could watch in a year, the cost of providing all of that stuff is falling towards zero by Moore's law. At the same time, the cost of what we could capture using mobile technology with the commissions on all mobile payments is increasing exponentially. So here's the question to you. Do you think we could find a point, an inflection point, and when would it be, where it would be possible using mobile technology to capture so much of your wealth that we could give you for free all the technology? So we say to you, so long as you open your wallet right now and you tear up all of your credit cards except one which you use for emergencies, no more than £500 a month, please, okay? One just for emergencies, and then put all the rest of your transactions through your mobile payment system. We will then give you the mobile, the everything else as well. Now, I put this to many banks. Whenever I'm with banks, I say it's about time you became telcos. Whenever I'm with telcos, I say it's about time you became banks. And I'm interested to know what you think their reaction is. Put your hands up if you think that most of their hands go up when I ask them, do you think this could happen in the next 5 to 10 years? Put your hands up if you think that's true. If you think such a thing could happen in the next 5 to 10 years, put your hands up. Well, most of the banks and telcos I talk to think that it could. And in fact, there are some countries which are already going down this particular path. Does it matter? Yes, it does. Could it change retail? Yes, it would. Who gains the revenue then? Interesting. Banks? Why banks? It all goes on the Vodafone bill. Do we need a back-end payment system anymore? What happens to checks? What happens to credit cards? What happens to it all? Not a lot. You couple it with biometrics. So latest phone, you put your thumbprint on, and at that moment it starts searching, and is looking for an SMS. Because as you put your thumbprint on the biometric receiver, it knows who you are, and it knows you're about to pay for something, and it captures the transaction. Bloop, it comes from the waiter or whatever it is. Bloop, up it comes. All you do is click on the payment and you press Y to pay. As you press Y to pay, you benefit from a European Union regulation which allows transactions, single transactions, to a value of up to €100,000. Because it's biometrics, it's more secure than any other payment system in the world. So that's enough to buy a boat, enough to buy a new car, and of course the finance is pre-approved, pre-assigned. So you've got your 10,000 floating credit, and you've got your £50,000 pre-assigned loan, so long as it's all cleared and all the metrics are done. So it's a change in the way we think about paying. It means that the idea of going to a phone shop and buying a piece of mobile technology, again, is looking rather old. Because why would you do that anymore? Because all the technology is free. It's just part of financial services. Now, I'm not saying that's going to happen, but I'm just asking us to consider how profound the digital revolution will become, and how we've hardly even begun to contemplate, perhaps, the very nature of what it will do to transform our consumer lifestyle.